Hello everyone, welcome back to a new video on SSO with Microsoft Azure AD. Previously I did a video on setting up SSO with the ADFS. You can find its link in the description. Please do watch it to get a clear understanding of how SSO works in ServiceNow. In this video, I'll be focusing on setting up SSO in ServiceNow with the Microsoft Azure AD. You can create a free account for Azure in their website azure.microsoft.com, and then you can use it to play around with it. I've already created an account for myself, and you can see once I log in, I would be redirected to the Azure portal here. In order to access Azure Active Directory, you can either access it from the left navigation here. You can go and open the Azure Active Directory, or you can also get it access from your Azure services under here. So let's go to the Azure Active Directory here. Once I open the Azure Active Directory, on the left navigation, you can see a list of menus which you can manage here. You can see the list of Active Directory users here. You can add new user, delete user, and manage the complete user attributes here. If I go back to the navigation, you can see you can also manage groups here. So you can create new groups. You can delete or manage these groups here. You can also synchronize this data with ServiceNow, the users and group, which I would be covering in a different video. The first thing that we need to do is to set up an application for ServiceNow. For this, I would go to my Active Directory menu. I'll go to the Enterprise application list. In this list, I need to add ServiceNow as a new application. I need to register with the ServiceNow application. So I would click on new application. I'll then search for ServiceNow here. You can see that ServiceNow app has come up. I would select this and then I would click on the create button. This would be adding the ServiceNow application to my Active Directory. So it would take some time to add it. The application has now been added to my Active Directory Enterprise application list. You can see the properties related to it, the application ID and the object ID. You can also see what are the other configurable options available with the ServiceNow application. We can assign users and group to this application. You can set up single sign-on. You can provision user account, that is to synchronize the information. You also have other options for self-service and conditional access. We'll be focusing on the first two options here, which is to assign users and groups to ServiceNow and also to set up a single sign-on. I need to first assign a user to the ServiceNow application. I won't be using my access ID here, but I would be creating a new user and assigning it to this application. To create a new user, I'll go back to my Active Directory. I'll go to users list and then I'll be creating a different user account. So I click on new user, then create user. I need to provide user details. So I would enter my username as Azure user. And you can see the domain name which is added to it. I would give a name for this user as Azure AD user. First name and Azure AD and last name as user. I need to provide a default password. We can either auto-generate or we can create a different password here. Let me set up a password. After entering the password, I would create this user record. So I click on create and the user has been successfully created. Now let's assign this user to the ServiceNow application. So for this, I'm going back to my navigation. I'll go to my enterprise application list. You would now see ServiceNow has populated here in the apps list. I'll go to the ServiceNow application and I would then go to assign users and groups and click on add user here. I can select my user from this list here. So I can add these two users at this moment. I'll be selecting the Azure AD user and I would click on select here and assign this user to my application. Now this specific user has access to my ServiceNow application. and he can also log in using this ServiceNow application SSO. The next step is to set up single sign-on for the ServiceNow application. For this, I will navigate to my single sign-on menu here. We'll be going for the SAML option, which is available in ServiceNow. I'll click on SAML. It would load me a page where you could set up single sign-on with SAML step by step. You have 5 different steps for it. The first thing is to set up your ServiceNow instance metadata. The second step is to generate your claims. Third step is to generate your SAML signing certificate. The fourth step is to set up your IDP in ServiceNow. The following details, which is the metadata of Azure AD. The fifth and last step is to test your connection with ServiceNow. If you want to have a detailed understanding of each of the steps, then you can watch my previous video on SSO with ADFS. So let's now proceed to the first step, which is to set up the metadata for ServiceNow. I'll click on edit for this basic SAML configuration. I need to input 3 different parameters here, which one is the identity URL, which is the entity ID. Then I need a reply URL, also a sign-on URL for ServiceNow. If you're not aware of this information, what you can do is go to your ServiceNow instance. You can navigate to your identity provider list. Open one of the out-of-the-box IDP. I would open SAML to update one. Then you can click on generate metadata here. This would open up the metadata for your ServiceNow instance. If you go through this XML information, you can see the entity ID for your instance is specified here. Just copy this and paste it back to your Azure configuration for SAML. I would paste this here. You can see I need to replace my instance name here. So I would copy my instance name from my ServiceNow instance and then I would paste it over here. The next thing I need is an assertion consumer service URL. If you check in this metadata again, you can see that you have the assertion consumer service default URL specified here. You can copy this location from here. This is nothing but your instance URL with the navpage.to suffix. So again, I need to replace my instance name here. So this would be my reply URL here. I would then copy this and add it back onto my sign-on URL, which is my actual URL where ServiceNow would sign me in after authentication. Once these 3 attributes are entered, you can click on Save. And this would be setting up your metadata in Azure AD. Once this is completed, you can proceed to your second step, which is setting up your user attributes and claims. So if I click on edit, you can see by default, the claims have been added in Azure. Azure is passing the user principal name. It's also passing my email address, given name and surname. You can see that the unique attribute or the name ID which is passed to ServiceNow is the user principal name. And we will be using this to authenticate the user record in ServiceNow. So this step is by default completed. So we'll come back to our next step here. We would go to the SAML signing certificate. You can see that the certificate is automatically populated once we have entered the SAML configuration detail here. If I click on edit, you can see certificate is now active. It has an expiry date till 2023. And this specific certificate would be used for authenticating requests coming from Microsoft Azure AD. The next step is to configure the IDP in ServiceNow. The best part of Azure is that you don't need to do this manually. Coming to step 4, you have an option to configure it automatically. For this, you would need to have a ServiceNow admin user account and password. So let me provide my admin username here and password. Once I enter my credentials, you can see an option to make this as a default identity provider. I won't be making this default until I test my IDP connection. So I would uncheck it and then I would click on the configure now button. What it does is it would automatically authenticate in my ServiceNow instance. It would then create an IDP with the settings which have been mentioned here. It would also add the certificate to my ServiceNow instance. So you can see that this configuration activity is now completed. So if you go back to my ServiceNow instance, and if I go to my IDP list here, you can see a new IDP has been created for Microsoft Azure. If I open it, you can see that all the metadata information from Azure SSO has been added to this IDP here. The next thing that I would do is to tag my Azure certificate to this IDP. For this, I would navigate to the bottom. Under the certificate list, I'll click on edit. I'd be able to see a new certificate that has been added from the Azure AD. So this is my certificate. I would add this to this IDP and click on save. Once the certificate has been added, you can test your connection within ServiceNow. Before testing this connection, I need to ensure that my AD user is present in my ServiceNow users list. Since I'm not automatically synchronizing the users from Azure to ServiceNow, the new user which I created in Azure does not exist in ServiceNow, so I would need to manually create that user in ServiceNow. If I navigate down to this Advanced tab, you can see that the user field which we have used is email address. So I need to make sure that the unique identifier coming from the Azure claims is matching with my email address. So let's go back to Azure and check our configuration for the unique claim. So if I go back to my Azure under user attributes and claim, you can see that I have used the user principal name as unique ID. To keep it a bit simple, what I would do is I would change this unique user identifier from the user principal name to the user email address. So I'll click on this and open this. Under the source attribute, you can change your unique identifier. So I would change it to user.mail, select it, and then save it. This changes my unique identifier to the email address. I can then map it with my ServiceNow email address. In order to test this, I need to provide an email address for my AD user. So I would go back to my Active Directory here. I'll open my user list and I need to provide an email address for this AD user. So I would click on edit and I need to modify the email address here. So let me provide a sample email as abc@example.com and I save this user record. Once this user record is saved, you need to ensure that this user record also exists in ServiceNow. Since we are not automatically synchronizing it, I need to manually create this user in ServiceNow. So I would navigate to my user table, click on new. I need to enter some details for this user. I'll provide the user ID as Azure user. Then I need to give a name as Azure AD, last name as user. I need to make sure the email address matches with the email address which I've provided here. So just copy this and then paste it over here, and then I would create a new record which is similar to the user profile in Azure. So I've created this user record. The next thing I would do is to test my connection. Before testing the connection, I need to make sure my IDP is set as the auto redirect IDP. For this, I would open my IDP, go to the related links, and I would set this as an auto redirect IDP. This would ensure that users are auto redirected to this SSO every time they access the instance. So let's try testing this out. So I'll copy my URL and open it in a new incognito window. So when I click on this, you can see that the instance is automatically redirected to the login page of Azure. I need to provide a sign-in name, which would be the user principal name, which I would copy from my Azure user. So this would be my sign-in name. Copy this, and I put it as my user sign-in. click on next. I need to enter a password here. If say first login, then you need to change your password. Since this was not my first login, I can directly log into the SSO. I click on sign in and it asks me whether I want to stay signed in. I'll click no for now. And once I click that, you can see that the user is redirected to the navpage.2 of the instance, and that is your home page. And I have successfully logged in to my user profile, which is Azure AD user. If I click on logout, you can see that it is redirecting me back to the Microsoft Azure logout page. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.